All right. So, tonight's stream is sponsored by the wonderful folks over at CorePunk. Their game is going into early access today. Now, what is CorePunk? The CorePunk early access trailer. Here is a look at it, and I will show you what this is.
Welcome to the world of CorePunk, an MMORPG where magic meets science and interdimensional travelers become part of each other's stories as they explore, survive, and thrive in their new home. Once you have created a hero of your own and travel through the portal from your home planet, you'll arrive in a rich and seamless open world full of dangers, mysteries, and adventure. Embark on epic quests.
I'll do it.
Great!
So make your fortune as a trader and master craftsperson by hoarding resources and creating special items, weapons, and artifacts with unique properties. Meet up with friends in the city and join forces to take on deadly monsters or other players. Use the fog of war to sneak up on your enemies and fight them together to claim victory. CorePunk is full of stories waiting to be told. What will your story be?
I really like the music. Oh my god, that's why you flank the dragon.
Join early access at CorePunk.com.
Alright, so that is CorePunk. For those interested, CorePunk.com, or there is a link pinned in the chat, or exclamation CorePunk pulls up the link. The pin is at the top of the YouTube and the Twitch streams. That goes to the website. Now, what is the game? The game is buy to play. It uses the classic model, like from when I was growing up. You buy the game once, and then it's yours. That's it. There's no subscription fee. There's no battle pass. There's nothing in the store that gives you power that you spend money on, anything like that. It's just classic buy to play if you are interested in it. And the goal tonight is to see if you are interested in it. So what I'm going to do now, I don't want this to show my login info, so I'm going to just use my big ugly mug here to hide my screen for a moment and log into the game. The game is not currently on Steam. I would love to see them get added to Steam. I think that would actually help them out, because then I could encourage you guys to wishlist it, but that's not currently an option. Oh my gosh, calm down. And is it your bedtime?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, give me a quick hug. Give me a quick hug.
That is not a hug. That is a headlock.
That is attempted murder.
It's a head hug.
That's a whole different thing.
It's not attempted murder.
Okay.
It
wouldn't have been attempted murder if I'd let you continue a few more seconds, because it would not have been an attempt. Okay. All right, let's do this and that. All right, love you too. Yes. Okay, so we're over here. All right, so as mentioned, CorePunk is an isometric open-world MMORPG that blends elements of some of your favorite gaming genres, MMOs, MOBAs, and action RPGs. They attempt to capture that nostalgic magic, bringing players back to the golden age of MMOs, reminiscent of the charm and excitement found in classics like old-school RuneScape and vanilla World of Warcraft. The early access launches today. It includes 3 unique biomes, 3 fully voiced episodes, deep itemization, crafting profession, 6 classes, with 1 new class added each month. So if you go to the website for this game, good night, buddy, there are other classes that you will see on the website that are not yet playable in the game yet. But we can explore up to 6 of them right now. So there's 1 new class added each month, and 12 world bosses. There are plans to add more modes, heroes, and features after early access. They're aiming to have 1.0 fully released by the end of 2025. But if you buy the game, you can play it right now. So with that, let's jump into it. The only thing I've done is I literally got to this screen. I installed it, I got to the screen, made sure it was working, turned down the volume a touch, and then I logged out. So let's see what's going on. We can see there's a lot of silhouettes here of other characters that we haven't seen yet. First off, we've got, I believe this is the race, and this is like your class. So there's male and female, so let's see, warmonger, legionary. If I change to female, is legionary still the first option?
Ah!
Okay, so it does not have, what is it called? Gender-locked classes, like a BDO, for example. So, let's see. This orc-looking character has Legionary. And, let's see, tanks who fight with spear and shield. They stun and slow enemies with their mighty strikes and blows and make them vulnerable to their abilities. So that is what they look like. Pretty rad. They've got Shield Bash. Oh, I love the games that have the little trailer that show you the thing in action. That's fantastic. Catapult. You can throw a mob at other mobs. Spear Throw. Okay. Sorry, it kind of reminds me of Pantheon a little bit. And Unstoppable. Remove all CC on themselves. For 8 seconds, they take reduced damage, gain bonus movement speed. The Legionary restores a portion of their health on an enemy killer assist. It doesn't appear to be on Steam. That is correct. It is not on Steam. It is, they have a standalone launcher, and there is a pin at the top of chat. Okay, the next class, it looks like there's 3 classes total for this race, and there's 2 available right now. The next one, that's pretty wild. It shows like the skeleton and everything. Is the Shaman with claw weapons, like taser weapons. Melee fighters coming from kindred of orcs who can talk with animal spirits and command the elements. Can you guys hear me okay, or is the background too loud? Let me know. Command the elements. They wield different fist weapons and mark enemies with basic attacks. Special ability, every third auto, the Shaman increases their attack speed by 5% for 7 seconds and gains a charge of elemental power. It's a little loud. Okay, let's go to settings. Let's do like that for now. Okay. When the number of charges reaches 5, they can summon the force of the elements to their aid and improve skills. By activating the special ability, the Shaman switches between the elements of fire, water, and earth over 1.5 seconds. Alright, so first move is Rip Apart. Quickly leap toward the target, preparing to deliver a series of destabilizing strikes. The next 4 auto attacks reduce the target's armor and magical resistances by 5 per auto for 6 seconds. With 5 charges of LE power, the target's immobilized for 2 seconds. Consumes all charges of special ability. Totemic Fury, passive. Through meditation, the Shaman increases both his and the wolf attack speed. Oh, you have a wolf? Active. With 5 charges of LE power, the Shaman can activate the skill and summon a totem within a 6-meter radius for 8 seconds. The type of totem depends on the chosen element. Fire Totem does spell, power, magical damage to an enemy within an 8-meter radius every 0.75 seconds. Okay, pulsing fire damage. Water Element is a healing totem. Restores spell power health to the Shaman and allies within a 4-meter radius every 0.75 seconds. Oh, that's awesome! So you've got healing magic and offensive magic. Earth Element is Wolf Totem. Enhances the Shaman's attacks by attack power within an 8-meter radius. Allies receive 50% of the enhancements. Totem consumes all charges of special ability. All right, I'm really liking this class so far. Lightning Strike, gather electricity from the atmosphere and releases lightning at the target. I think we got a glitch with this one. Do you guys see the little trailer video? She looks at the enemy and she just T-poses at them. Okay, so I guess the lightning is still in transit. With 5 charges of LE power, the cast is instant. Consume all charges of the special ability. So you can just T-pose on your enemies. Call of the Wild. Summon a wolf. There's a strong spiritual connection between the wolf and the Shaman. The attack power, attack speed, health and armor, and magical resist of the wolf are 50% of the Shaman's stats. If the wolf dies, the Shaman loses 20% of their health. Oh, I like that. That's kind of like D&D familiar rules. Like the thing, your summon growing with a percentage of your power, and if it dies, it's like you get punched in the brain. Direction to the enemy. The wolf's attacks the designated target, and every 5th attack does additional damage. Direction to the Shaman. The wolf returns to the Shaman. Direction to the wolf. The Shaman casts a channeled spell and transfers a portion of his health to the wolf during 5 seconds. You lose 1% health, and the wolf gains 3% health per second. Okay. So you've got pet controls and a pet heal. That's solid. Direction to the position. The wolf runs to the specified place and stays there. If the Shaman moves 20 meters away, the wolf returns. Okay. This is my favorite of the 2 classes I've seen so far. We have got, it looks like, 2 more races that each have 2 classes. So what is this race called? The Bombers. Oh, the music. Oh, they've got their own music, too. Okay, so this is the Bomber chat. It kind of reminds me of Torchlight. Any of y'all played that? Oh, I didn't see this down here. Coming of age in a concrete jungle amid warring street gangs, bright and youthful bombers had to wise up early. They fend off of themselves using trickery and razor-sharp wit. Speed is their advantage, explosives their best friend. Bombers are unrivaled when it comes to illusions and hoaxes. They might seem like they're just playing with matches, but watch out, or their little games might be the last thing you see before you die. Can you? Oh yeah, I move him for now. Really quickly, I wanted to go see what the backstory was for this guy. Okay, warmongers. Only the strongest of the orcs can become warmongers. Hardened by innumerable battles, they won't be stopped by any threat. With countless combats under their belt, warmongers are skilled warriors, fearing neither pain nor death itself. They can bring down enemies with suppressive heavy fire or hold the front line with spear and shield. If necessary, warmongers can summon a forest beast to help them. Okay. Alright, so let's go back to the bomber. Alright, so, bomber's first thing is infiltrator. Melee assassin who deals massive damage in a short amount of time. They can use double daggers and mines. They can become invisible to foes and easily finish off enemies with low health. Okay. Attacks and abilities directed at an enemy's back receive a bonus of 10% adaptive. The bomber can activate a special and throw a dagger in the chosen direction, followed by a second dagger within 2 seconds. Upon hitting the target, the dagger impales and deals 100% damage. Cooldown is 30 seconds. After using a special, the bomber remains unarmed for 5 seconds. So, it's like you threw your actual knife. You don't have a weapon for 5 seconds, then you get it back. Okay. Camouflage. Infiltrator uses a device and transitions into invisibility for 7 seconds over 2 seconds. So I'm thinking about this. Assuming this is a skill shot, then it would be really bad if you threw this and missed. Because then you literally just chuck your weapon and you gain nothing, and then it'd be gone for 5 seconds if you don't land it. But I don't know if it's a skill shot or not. All right, camo. Invisibility for 7 seconds after 2 seconds. Movement speed is reduced by 20%. Any action breaks the invis. First damage from invisibility catches enemy off guard, preventing them from using abilities for 2 seconds. So it's like a silence. Branch stat increases invis duration by 1 second per talent. Mine throw. Infiltrator throws a mine to the specified location. Upon landing, the mine burrows into the ground after 1 second, activates, and becomes invisible for 30 seconds. If an enemy is within a 2-meter radius of the active mine, it detonates, dealing fizz damage, and applies a slowing effect to all enemies damaged by the ability for 3 seconds. I'm immediately reminded of StarCraft's Vulture Spider Mines. The mine instantly detonates if an enemy is within 1-meter radius of its landing location. Only one mine can be active at a time. Branch stat increases duration. Carpet bombing. Okay, so again, it looks like the little video is not quite done yet, but we can get the general idea. Throw a cluster of grenades on the ground in front of them with a width of 3 meters. All enemy targets in the area receive electric shock, doing fizz damage with 100% spell power. Additionally, they're rooted for 2 seconds. I'm reminded of Jinx's little bitey grenades. Street violence. Infiltrator shadow steps into the specified area and upon landing does physical damage to the nearest enemy within a 2-meter radius. If their remaining health after the damage is at 5% or lower, it just instantly kills them. If the enemy's killed, the ability recharges instantly. Okay. Alright, second option for the bombers. Blast medic. Okay. Range support hero who uses grenade launcher and can wield various explosives. They heal allies, buff them, or use crowd control against enemies, or create illusions to trick them. Special. The bomber begins cycling through enhancements. After activation, the effect changes every 0.6 seconds. Reactivating the ability activates the current enhancement. Enhancement 1, outgoing and healing is increased by 20%. Number 2, the bomber delivers 3 auto attacks at maximum attack speed. 3, inflicts magical damage is increased by 20%. First skill, dual purpose bouncy bomb. The blast medic throws a bomb, which deals magic damage to enemies and heals allies. With every ricochet, the damage dealt to enemies increases, and the healing effect to allies decreases. Interesting. So if there's an enemy you're trying to kill, you don't aim at them, you aim at something near them. If there's an ally you're trying to heal, you do aim at them first. The blast medic will need some time to use the ability. It can be cast while you're moving. Who was it in Heroes of the Storm? Was it Alexei Stukov that had an ability like this? I think it was him. I loved that guy in that game. I think it was him. Flashbang Shield Generator. The Blast Medic throws a bomb to a target area. The Blast Medic and ally, Blast Medic and allies who were in the range of the explosion are shielded. Okay. Hollow Decoy Projector. The Blast Medic creates the duplicate and sends it to a target direction. When the ability is recasted on the duplicate, the Blast Medic swaps places with the duplicate. Passing through enemies, the Blast Medic deals magic damage and regenerates health of allies they pass through. It's kind of like Echo, but different at the same time. Omnifunction Drive. The Blasmedic sends a drone to a target hero. The drone is active for 20 seconds. If a target's an ally, they are buffed with periodic healing. A target gains bonus movement speed. If a target is the Blasmedic, they are shielded. While the Blasmedic is shielded, their incoming damage will be decreased and he reflects 10% of incoming damage. If the target's an enemy, they are debuffed, taking additional magic damage alongside the damage dealt by basic attacks. It's Zenyatta's orbs. Except for the shield part. It's Zenyatta's orbs. Okay, that's pretty neat. All right, so we got one. It appears we have one race left that is playable at this time, and that's these guys. Oh, shoot, he looks cool. What? Champions. Noble warriors. Champions seek out battles and live for glory. They unleash their rage upon their foes like an unstoppable hurricane of power, breaking them with ease and knocking the absolute stuffing out of them. It actually says that. Champions bravely rush into battle, launching a volley of arrows, striking enemies with their mighty sword and shield. Their proud spirit, valor, and nerves of steel never let champions down and fight, bringing them victory after victory. Tech Samurai, yeah. I like it. Okay, the Destroyer. Melee heroes with a spec and two-handed weapons. They sweep right into battle, dealing massive damage. Fighting in a group, they can support allies, restoring their health. Special. For each basic attack or use of an ability which hits an enemy, the Destroyer gains 1% bonus attack speed. The buff stacks up to 10 charges. The charge lasts 10 seconds and refreshes. Activation of the special ability is available on 10 charges only, and the Destroyer starts to whirl, dealing fizz damage with her weapon every 0.75 seconds to all nearby enemies during 5 seconds. After that, all empower charges fall off. So if you get 10 stacks, you can Bladestorm. Alright, charge. The Destroyer charges to a target and deals fizz damage in an area in front of them. All enemies affected by this are slowed. Circle Strike. Perform a circular strike, dealing fizz damage. The area has two radius zones of impact. Enemies caught within the outer radius zone take increased damage. Oh, just the tip. What is it? Mind the Gap, I think, on the new Mesmer Spear. It's got the same mechanic. Warcry. The champion lets out a roar and gains a 20-second buff that increases health and attack power. Crushing Leap. The Destroyer performs a leap to the specified location. Upon landing, it inflicts fizz damage and stuns all enemies in the area for 3 seconds. Okay. All right, and the last one available right now to play. The Ranger. Still kind of has that Tech Samurai vibe with a giant, almost compound bow. Uses bows and arrows. Toggling between two stances, they can deal damage in an area or to a particular target. They can be the ones to deal the most damage and can root and slow enemies. Special. Basic attacks leave arrows in enemies. The Ranger gains bonus attack speed for each arrow. The effect stacks 10 times. The special ability can be activated, which triggers an explosion of all arrows stuck in enemies, dealing physical damage. Net Shot. Fire an arrow with a net in a target direction. That's a good graphic for the net. Which does physical damage to the first enemy it hits in its path, rooting them. Santa says, hey, Muck, did you have any issues with logging into your account to activate your key? I was not able to do it until after 5 p.m. today. I think that their servers for the early access didn't completely come up till after 5 p.m. So I had issues before that, but after that I was able to do it. Let's see. Arrow Rain. The Ranger chooses a target area, which for the next 2 seconds is attacked with a hail of arrows, dealing fizz damage once per second. All enemies in the area are slowed. Okay, so that's Barrage. And then this is called Barrage Stance. The Ranger can toggle between two stances. While in Stand Art Stance, or small typo there, the Rangers have Stand Art basic attacks. Wait, did they mean to do that? Is Stand Art? Okay, now I'm wondering if Stand Art is a word and I'm just stupid. When switching to Barrage Stance, basic attack damage is reduced by 50%, but does fizz damage to the two nearest targets with on-hit effects. Okay, so you've got a single target damage stance and an AoE stance, basically. Saltation. The Ranger fires a volley of arrows in front of them, dealing physical damage to all enemies affected by the ability. The Ranger will leap 4 meters back. What's the lady look like? Sure, hang on. Shorter skirt. It increases armor class. So that's the, what is it called? The infiltrator. She She's got like TV screens on her shins. And that's the blast medic. That's the shaman. Okay. Alright, so. There are other classes, and there are other races. Many of them you can see on the website right now. However, there are 6 available to play right now, because we are on day 1 of early access. Ever since I read it, I got my eye on the shaman. I like that it has the healing totem. That's some sustain. The wolf pet is icing on the cake. Also, fun fact, the first muckluck in World of Warcraft was an orc shaman. So this, to me, it feels like fate. So I'm gonna play this strapping lad right here. Okay, customization. Oh boy, yo, we just went back to the Stone Age, didn't we? Let's see, presets? Oh my God, where's the undo button? Let's see, outfit, brown outfit. All right, this is just like colors. Okay, head options. Let's see, we'll do that one. Hairstyle. Oh, that's like the Grom Hell Scream. Oh my goodness. Oh man. Might have to go for the Grom. Facial features. There we go. Shirt costs extra, yeah. I'm pretty happy with the colors. That's all fine. All right. Name Muckluck. Okay. Enter world. Position in queue. What? There's a queue? Oh, no. Well, I hope that doesn't take too long. Okay, good. Dude, imagine me going back to the company like, hey, I totally tried to do the thing you paid me for, but I couldn't log in. do I still get paid? Peak MMO experience day 1, right? Let's see. Venturing into the forest. Stock up on food because I couldn't read all that. Combat or chill? Feeling fierce or want to relax? Press P to switch between combat mode and peaceful mode. Whether you're in the mood for a brawler or stroll, we got you covered.
Please speak to the Outworlder welcoming specialist. He's supposed to be in the closest proximity. Don't die and have a nice day.
Okay. Ready to explore the world. Click around with your right mouse button to move. It's like pointing your finger and saying go there, but with more style and fewer sore feet.
Getting me steps up.
Can I? Okay, so tap, hold the right. Okay, I can hold it if I want to.
Another newcomer.
Well, I can mouse wheel in and out.
Your head hasn't blown up yet. A good sign already.
Okay. Quest.
Do you even know how many laws you've broken by coming out of this pool?
No.
No.
Well, at least you're honest. I don't know either. Anyway, you have to be registered. Standard procedure. I just don't have any blank forms left. There are some spare forms by my house, on the table outside. Get going and find them.
Alright.
I'll do it.
You know, you look pale.
Camera control. Do you need a different perspective? Press L to lock or unlock your camera. Sometimes you want to see the world, and sometimes you just want to see your shoes. Push the mouse to your sides of your screen to move your view. While using unlocked camera, you can press and hold tab to recenter above your character.
What a slog.
Harvesting builds character. While venturing through the world, you'll harvest different nodes. Bushes with colorful flowers that stick out among the foliage. Drag your mouse over the resources, and if they're highlighted, they're harvestable. Right-click on them while standing by to collect the materials. It's hard work, but someone's got to do it. Why did that just pop up? Did I pass one? Or maybe that other guy got it.
I like it over here.
I like it over here. Find the form. Can I talk to the little robot?
Salutations, life form.
How are you?
All good with you?
As a bot, I do not experience physical or emotional states. However, your concern has been acknowledged. Any further inquiries can be addressed to the welcoming specialist in the robotic exoskeleton to my right.
Oh, here we go. Take Bush.
Take loot.
Take loot.
You're going to find a ton of items around the world that you want to pick up. Never miss anything by holding left alt and highlighting all those sweet pieces of booty that are left around enemies' crates or barrels. It's not looking good. I don't have skills yet.
Hello, organism.
Alright, you DPS, I'll kite. Alright, trade jobs. Everyone team up. It's the final boss. All level ones work together. Oh no, he called in backup. What is going on? Is this Ashes of Creation? Oh my god. They're AoEing them down. Avoid the red. Red is bad. Oh my god. All right, I got an idea. Y'all hold that last one. I'm going over here.
Stop by and introduce your sorry ass to Maxwell.
Yeah. Okay, hold on a sec. Like, how do I get the heal? Like Totemic Fury. Well, I put a point in it. It doesn't let me use it right now. Campfire? Oh, I can heal at the campfire. Okay. Let's see. Health regen increase by 4.8 max health per second. Mana regen increase per second. Food efficiency increased by 50% for 5 minutes. Okay. All right, so the totem thing is, okay, so the totem, I gotta get charges. So I think I gotta beat on the enemy to get charges, then I can use this. I don't know how to, like, go into a certain element yet. 6 hours later. No, it's fine, it's fine. The good old online experience, yeah. Okay, full health again. And there's a blinky sign here. Is this where the papers are? Maxwell's Rubik's Cube. Am I missing something here? Smelly sock. Smelly smoky? Is this the house? Find newcomer form.
Bulldozer.
Garson said, what strategies do you think that Core Punk players can use to optimize their talent branch choices and weapon specialization talents for both PvP and PvE game modes, given the game's unique fog of war mechanic class flexibility? Additionally, how do you foresee the dynamic day-night cycles and weather effects influencing exploration and player interactions on both cooperative and competitive settings? 42, definitely. Alright, I don't know if this is where the quest item is, or if I just keep going.
Big guy on the move.
What was I doing? Lost your way or forgot your quest? Check the reminder.
On you so I can keep an eye on you. All in the name of safety, of course. The newcomer form should be on the table outside, or in the porch. Might have left it in the mailbox, too. No clue, really.
Or in the mailbox. Is this his house? Or is this house further ahead? That blinky sign makes me think it's, like, right here. But...
got to get moving.
How's this guy level 4? He's cheating. Let's have newcomers. I don't see a mailbox. I'm thinking that his house is further ahead. Because he said, like, my house, and that's just a tent, and he mentioned his mailbox. I didn't see a mailbox. So I'm gonna go further ahead and hope his house is up there.
going for a mosey.
Going for a mosey.